Hello, welcome to 8.1b, continuous exponential distributions. Here we have a graph of the exponential distribution. The continuous exponential distribution is used to predict the waiting time between consecutive events in a random sequence of events. So basically, it's very similar to the geometric distribution for discrete probabilities. So again, we're concerned with waiting times. To receive a phone call, how many minutes do you have to wait until that call occurs? So here we have the distribution graph. Again, we're looking for the cumulative value, below a value. It's an area under the curve. And the formula we're going to use is x is less than or equal to little x. Little x is the value, equals 1 minus e negative k to the x. Where k is equal to 1 over mu, which is the mean, and e is 2.71828, which is your constant on your calculator. So look for the e to the x button on your calculator. Okay, so an example. So at the KNI call center, average wait time between phone calls, our tech support line is 2 minutes, and it's exponentially distributed. Determine the formula modeling the situation. Okay, so we use our formula. So the probability for x is less than or equal to x equal to 1 minus e to the negative kx. So I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's a negative in front of the kx. So in this case, k is equal to 1 over mu, which is 1 over 2, so it's a half. So k has a value of a half. So therefore, the formula is 1 minus e to the negative 1 half x. So using that formula, we can solve the next problem. So what is the probability that we have to wait 2 minutes or less between calls? So here we put it in the formula. So x is equal to 2. So that makes that e to the negative 1. So 1 minus e to the negative 1 is 0.63, or 63%. And a little graph. Something like that. Best to my painting abilities. I apologize for the not so nice smooth line. What's the next part is what's probably waiting at most 60 or 30 seconds. Oops. We need to edit our formula. Since it says at most, that means that we're actually waiting from 30 seconds to infinity. So we need to actually invert that question. Okay. So this might be a mistake. I apologize. I'll have to fix that tomorrow. Okay. So on to the next question. Determine the probability the technician will wait between 2 and 3 minutes before a call comes. So in this case, we actually have to do a couple of calculations and then subtract them. So we have here x equals 3 minus x equals 2. So if we do the graph, there'd be a little space in between that interval between 2 and 3. So that's why we have to subtract 2 from 3 because we don't want from 2 beyond, 2 below. So we just want the little interval. So this is the value of probability for less than 3, and this is the probability for less than 2, which we saw in the previous question. So we subtract them. So the probability that we'll land between 2 and 3 is about 14.5%. So here's some homework questions. Let's try them. 7, 8, 9. 8 and 9, we'll see where the formula comes from that we discussed. And question 8 is the formula that we're using, which gives you the area under the curve up to the point. And the formula in question 9 is actually just that one point, the specific point, so we don't usually use it too often, but it's there just so you can see what's going on. So when you get to calculus in grade and first year university and you do antiderivatives integration, that's what we're doing. Right, so have a good night and hopefully this works. See you tomorrow.